Okay, so in this episode, we are actually going to create new posts. That means we are having this form, and in this form, we will fill the data and save everything on the database. So with that, I'm your host Sarthak, and this is a channel where I talk about Laravel. And the cool thing about Laravel, someone has posted me and he said that I'm incorrect for the pronunciation of the Laravel. It's Laravel. And I'm saying Laravel, so I apologize because I actually don't know what's the actual pronunciation. So I think it doesn't matter because we love Laravel. Laravel, it doesn't matter. So I will try to change my accent and try to call it Laravel. But again, Laravel is in my habit, and I will try to change this. And please prompt me whenever I say Laravel. So Laravel. So Laravel, and don't forget to subscribe and like Bitfumes on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. So let's create, and in our Laravel block series, let's begin. So we have all these things. We have created many routes here. We have created users here. So sidebar, close tag. Yeah. So now we want to have data here, and whenever I click submit, this submit button, I want to submit this data in our database. So here is the database. So where is that block series we have given, and here is the post table. Yeah, so here is the post table. So let's just create that thing and we will see how we can move forward. So let's first see what we are getting on that page. So I will go to admin post, and here is the post.blade. So here where we have form, yeah, here is the form, but it's only for text area, but we need that form for whole of that thing. So yeah, this is the form, and that form is starting where here. So role is form, action, yeah, it's very important. Action is that on which route or on which function you are actually posting your data. So I will say again, as we always do, I will say route. Route name is, because we are going to post dot create. So think they missed one more. Yeah, so let's just open app HTTP controller admin post controller. So here we have, so here we are returning this, and now we have to store. So instead of create, I have to give a store here. So this will go to this function. The data from the form will come here, because you can see here it's request. So this is the request function, which is having everything from the form inside this request array. So this thing is here, and now we have to give the method, which is post. And the most important thing, because we are on Laravel, and we need to say CSRF underscore field also here. So otherwise we will get error. So let's see, first name we have title, second is subtitle, we have again name, slug name is here, file is here, checkbox, yes, status, and it's a body. Oh, which button it is? Oh, okay, that's the close button. Okay, and here the body, everything is here. So let's do one thing here inside this store. I will return what? Request arrow all. So everything inside request I'm going to return. So actually what happening here, let's just firstly refresh this page, give it this is first title. Subtitle is simply subtitle, doesn't matter. This is title. Okay, and I don't want to choose any file for now. Body is simply body. Let's just submit it. And let's see what happened. Okay, you know what? It's not working because we are on user create. We have to say here post slash create. Okay, and now let's try to submit it. And yes, we have everything null. So now type here the title. Okay, so now type here this is first title and subtitle slug, simply slug. And no, that will not this. Yes, same thing. Submit it. And you can see we have everything here. So we have body here. We have image null. Yeah, okay. Slug, subtitle and title. Okay, that will be for WYSIWYG HTML5. That means this text area, some kind of things. Okay, doesn't matter. We don't have to store these things. Okay, so we have these things, and these things is here because on our, let's open that, the post controller, we are returning request all. So now what I have to do, I have to create these new things, but before creating, I have to validate these things so that everything is here and user cannot submit the form until and unless he has filled all these things. So let's just firstly do this. So I will say this arrow validate, and inside here I have first argument as request and second is the same validation. So firstly the title will have required field, so required, and subtitle also required, so required, and same thing for slug and also body. Okay, so these are the things, and the importance of this validation is that whenever you are submitting this form empty, it will return back to the same route. You don't have to say if validation failed, return to that original route. No, it will smart enough to return to that page with errors. So what actually I can do, I can open here and above the form, just where above the form here after this titles, I will say here firstly if count dollar errors having greater than zero, then inside that I think here we will create a for each loop which say errors arrow all will get error. Okay, and for every error I want to show inside a p tag which having class of alert danger, and just echo out the error. Save this file, go back, refresh and submit it, and yes, you can see it's having all these errors here. Okay, so this is I think the most unique thing. So we don't have to say anything. It's just saying the title field is required, subtitle field is required, slug, and this is coming from the name. If I give this my title name as my title, okay, refresh and submit, you can see, okay, yeah, because I have to say here also. So that's why it's giving. Okay, my title is required, so submit, and yes, my title is required. So these are the things, you can change it. Okay, so it's here, and let's now create this form. After validation we have these validations, now we have to create this. So firstly what we want for creating anything, we need to connect to database. And for dealing with the database, we need model. You know, in one of our episode, we have created the model. So now we have to call that model. So the model which are using for the post is simply the post model. So for the post model, we are going to create. We are going to create, or even you can use like this. So I will say dollar post. We will create a new instance of this post model, and I will say post arrow title is equal to request arrow title title. Okay, and same thing for slug, for subtitle, for body. So firstly this one, which is subtitle, then we have this one, so we can say slug, then we have this one which is body, and after that we can say post arrow save. Okay, and it will save everything into your database. So these are the things. So let's just see, we have connected the database. Yeah, actually we have connected because we have all these migration created. So yes, we have these things. So let's just do one thing, go here, fill these forms. So I will refresh it, so error are gone, and now this is first title. Yeah, you're right, you're right. Anything wishes. Okay, and this is first title, make it bold, make it italic, move it here. Oops, that's not moving. Yeah, move it here, and it's good. Okay, so now submit, and it's having error. So this is giving error because it doesn't know what the post is. Actually we have to import it at the top, like we have request, we have controller. So I will use this PHP companion. So I will say use, and you can see PHP companion find use. It will just import this at the top, and if you're not familiar with this, you can check out the Sublime series I have, and link is in the description. So I will say use it at the top, and you can see, oops, it's not even okay. So yeah, because it's a small p. So now let's find its use. Yes, so now we have this use it at the top. Yes, it's here. So these are the things, so that's why it's not getting okay. So go refresh again, and it's saying all lots of things. Status doesn't have default value. Whenever you say, you will feel this kind of error. You will have to look for your database, and you can see status we are not providing, and it's having null value. So whenever we are not providing null value, we want to have default of zero. And again, we can allow null for image, and posted by also we can allow it to be null for now, and like and dislike also. Okay, so these are the things we can allow to be null, but these things cannot be null. Okay, so go here, refresh, and yes, we are having no error. That means we are having data on our database. But what this blank page refers, because after saving we have not redirected anywhere. So just return redirect, and after that we want to redirect to that create route. So instead of here, I will again say route of post dot create, no, post dot index will be fine. Post dot index, yeah, semicolon is here. So refresh, continue, and yes, we are on the post dot index. That means the show the index function of the post controller. So now we have two fields here. So this is because we have blocked in the middle of thing, but whenever you redirect here, so that will be never going to happen, this two kind of same thing in the database. So in this way we can save the data inside post, and in the next episode we are going to create these things for category and tag, and we will move very fast, and I think it's not very fast, but we will move step by step. So I think you are liking this series, and if you like, please give it thumbs up. Please share this videos with your developer friend so that everyone know how you can use the Laravel to create big project. And don't forget to subscribe and like Bitfumes on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram. And we will meet in the next episode. Till then, bye bye. Okay, bye.